And we're back.
I forgot the knife, so we're using a drill bit. Look, it works.
Nice.
And here it is. Guys, gals, and automobiles. We've got the Boba Fett prototype armor helmet, aka Hasbro's do-it-your-own Mando helmet, as the internet has answered with. I've seen so many different customizations for this thing. Oh, wow, they really fucking... They beat the shit out of this box. Okay, cool. So, I guess that I don't know. I'll probably keep the box to display next to, like, the Stormtrooper helmet box and all of that shit, but that's pretty ugly. I don't like that. So yeah, there is a huge bunch of stuff there. You can go ahead and pause it to read that. I'm just gonna keep flashing these sides, and then we're gonna get into this bitch. Because, welcome to the expansion of the channel. We're now not only doing unboxings and reviews, but now we're gonna start doing customization videos. As you can tell, because you clicked on the thumbnail for this video. So yeah, I'm gonna get this bitch out of the box so we can take a look. All right, so in the box are three things. The rangefinder, the instructions, we don't need those, come on, and the bucket itself. And this thing is phenomenal. Holding it in hand is just... It's like a dream come true, you know? Like, everybody wants their own Mando helmet. And, I just gotta say, they used a completely new sculpt for the dome of the helmet. But they did not use a new sculpt for the lower portion of the helmet. So it has, I'm not sure how well it's going to get picked. Yep, there you go. It has all sorts of imperfections in the paint itself. So that's not pretty, you know. Not a huge fan of that. Just because, like, what's the point of making the top one? And especially if you look inside of the helmet, which the inside is phenomenal. Just the amount of detail and, like, that they really could have just made it plain in here. You know, like, not done anything with it. But they really went extra with it. Like, it is gorgeous in there. So I'm gonna put the batteries in, and we're gonna attach the rangefinder and show you all of the fun little lights and sounds functions. And just so everybody knows, the battery goes in under the right ear cover muff piece thing. And the rangefinder just clicks on with a really good push. All right, so the only light and sound or anything functionality that this thing has, as far as I know, is that right there. The rangefinder swings down, and then it's got the lit up screen on it, and like little targeting indicators. Jesus. And then this just sloop, slides right back on, flicks right back up. I don't think I like this mechanism. It feels very chintzy to me. Feels very loose. I'm really not sure how I feel about it. But it is cool that it has it nonetheless. Like, and that's part of why I kind of wish that it was motorized. I had heard that it was. That you, like, press the button and it would slowly come down. Like, I feel like that would be much better, because when you do this and it gets that bounce to it, I feel like that's a lot of stress on the arm. So I don't know that I will be bringing the rangefinder down, especially I put the helmet on and the rangefinder doesn't even line up with my eye. And that has to be the one complaint that I have about the helmet, is that when I'm wearing it, it's very hard to see out of. I feel like maybe it's just my head shape, but I feel like my eyes don't line up with the visor. But yeah, so we are going to put a pin in this, and we're going to start working on customization. All right, so I have two different coarsenesses of sanding sponges. I'm going to use these to rough up the surface so that it will be more accepting of the paint that I'm going to put on it. All right, not sure how well you're able to see it, but I went ahead and sanded the whole thing down. Didn't sand this down at all because I'm going to be leaving the wayfinder or the rangefinder the way it is. Fucking wayfinder, this ain't Rise of Skywalker. So yeah, I'm going to go wipe this bitch off, and I'm going to take you guys outside so that we can do some priming. Because I originally did the sanding because I was nervous about, you know, actually, like, priming this thing, but we're just going to say fuck it. Maybe? No? Maybe? I don't know. What do you guys think? Now we're just going to paint this bitch. We're going to paint this bitch. We're going to go wild. It's cold outside, so the primer's not going to fucking stick anyways. We're going to see how it goes. Fuck it. Let's get wild. We're trying new things here. We're trying new things on the channel. We got this. All right. Tilt you up a bit. All right. So. Come on, fuck boy. There we go. All right. So. Now we're just going to wipe it down. Also, I forgot to mention it before I did it, but take the side plates off. It's going to make it a lot easier when you paint. Oh, whoopsie doopsie. Click. All right. Now, we're going to do a base coat of black acrylic. So, I don't have an easel, so I'm just using the instructions. That's how you paint, right? All right, day two. So, I realized halfway through doing yesterday's video that I was out of gold paint. So, can't really paint a helmet gold without gold paint. So, I had to wrap up filming yesterday, and today I went and got the gold paint that I needed. And if this could just go to the right angle, gorgeous. So, picked up some folk art multi-surface. Here, let's go ahead and get the flash on. Beautiful. Multi-surface, 14 karat gold. And then I also picked up, because I was out, some silver rub and buff and some antique gold rub and buff. So, let's get started. Alright, so I'm holding it very awkwardly right now because the paint is currently drying. But as you see, I put the gold around the border of the visor, on the ear caps, and around the back. Next, we're going to be filling in this part here with silver. I used a 2-inch roller brush, this puppy right here, and I got it a little bit damp. So, I'm not sure if you can see, but it almost makes it look like there's a black wash over it already. Got a little bit on the visor, that's fine, that'll scrub right off. That's, you know, I should have taped it off, that's my own fault. But yeah, so next we're going to, fill in this with silver, and then, just kind of rub and buff the entire thing. So, yeah. Alrighty, so for the last part, I'm just gonna go ahead and freehand it, because I'm gonna be turning this puppy around. So, this is the helmet now. After rub and buff, and weathering, and clear coating, yeah, this thing was stark white when we got our hands on it. And now, woo! Got that triple paint effect. So it looks like it was done like it was originally silver, and then black, and then gold. Yeah, got the and then, see, this is why we sanded the top of it. That way, once we get it all painted, it looks nice and scuffed up. And then it kind of gives us guidelines for, you know, where to weather and remove paint as well. Got the rear vent. I messed up a little bit. You can see that I got some silver on where it's supposed to be black in there. So I'm going to touch that up. But otherwise, I got that nice and dirtied up. And, yeah. No, it, sorry, didn't mean to turn the camera there. All right. Yeah, no, I'm very satisfied with, the way that the final product is looking. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. This is going to be the first in my new line of, you know, customizing videos and doing prop replicas and things like that. So, yeah, thanks for joining. I was originally going to start with that Boba Fett helmet, but I fucked it up and couldn't get it put back together. So that's why we're starting with this puppy. All right, I love you guys. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and I will see you next time.